Pisces and cross watchers, thank you guys so much for joining in. Hope everyone is doing well. Today we are going to take a look at your monthly broken heart tarot spread for March. Okay, in this reading we are going to take a look at your part of the problem, your person's part, what you each can do, other influences, can it be saved, and is it worth it? Okay, we are first going to tap in with the Island Time Wellness Love Oracle deck. So, let's get started. Please keep in mind, guys, the messages on YouTube are general. They're not going to resonate every time with every person. You're more than welcome to check other signs within your birth chart. It's really about the title. If there's something in the title, there's most likely something in the message. Also, energy and time are fluid, so you may find it resonates now. Some may find it resonates later. You will know if the message is meant for you, if it hits you, if you feel it, okay? You gotta feel it in your gut. So let's get started here. Please, Spirit, we thank you for the most positive and guiding message for our subscribers. Please allow clear and concise message coming through to our viewers. Please protect me, the viewer, and the cards from any negative energies. And thank you again, Spirit. Blessed be. All right, Pisces, let's see what we got for you guys coming out for the month of March. I'm switching up things a little bit here, guys, if you haven't noticed. I'm doing the weeklies and then a themed monthly reading every week, okay? I also have a few new announcements coming up. I will have a video specifically for the announcements. And if you guys are interested in still getting entered into the drawing, I pull several subscribers every month for free personal readings. So if you want to get entered into that drawing, make sure you subscribe to the channel. If you want to be notified when I upload videos, hit the notification bell. So, Pisces. Healthy choices, making healthy choices in love and in life, self-love, self-care, self-healing, beautiful, beautiful energy. Let's see. Not today. I'm not dealing with this BS today. Still mad about this situation. That's what I'm hearing. Let's see. Self-indulgence and the snake. TikTok. So, there's somebody that is trying to cause harm. This could be spiritual, psychic, physical. The snake symbolizes malice, ill intent. Could also symbolize the other woman, but I'm picking up the sense that somebody is trying to sabotage what you have going on, Pisces. Protect yourself. You may need to do some shadow work to heal those parts of you that are hidden. Also, get the sense here there is a need to focus on self-care. So getting in a self-care routine, incorporating time alone for yourself will be beneficial in this. So let's see here, Pisces, what we can see with the tarot cards. Most important message here for Pisces. What does Pisces need to see about the snake? Snake in the grass. Let's see. Most important message here for Pisces Spirit. What does Pisces need to see for the month of March? What is their part of the problem? What is their part in all of this? Please and thank you. Okay. The Queen of Wands is very passionate, right? Nurturing, loving energy, but it can also be over passionate, and I feel like that's what this is coming out as, is you're maybe a little too passionate for this person, meaning you overextend yourself a lot when it comes to this person. You may also hang on their every word, cater to their every need. That type of vibe is what I'm getting here, okay? And I feel like this person is seeing that you have this dedication and this loyalty for them. Let's see, because I feel like they're purposefully causing some delays here, meaning that they very well could be sabotaging purposefully. It's like they're dangling something over your head. You're gonna have to let me know in the comments what's going on here, because for some of you, whatever they're dangling, I feel like that may be why you're kind of catering to their every word, okay? But I do get the sense that this is going to come to an end here. There's going to be some movement forward. Let's get a couple more cards out here, and then we'll get some clarification on all of this. But I do feel here, Pisces, there's the self-care card. There's definitely a need here for focusing more on self. Okay, than this other person. If there is something that they're hanging over your head, maybe it's time to correct that behavior pattern that they're trying to hang over your head. One more card, Spirit, please, and thank you for Pisces. For March. I feel like this could work, okay? They're gonna be a need to call out on their behavior. There's gonna be a need to call them out. I also feel here, we have justice on the bottom. We'll get some clarification, but I also feel here, Pisces, that this person may think that you're so in love with them that you would never leave the situation. And I feel like they're wrong. I feel like you will put your foot down. You will walk away from this connection if you need to. It doesn't necessarily mean that you'll walk away to another person. It just means that you will put your foot down and not allow this sabotaging behavior going on anymore. Okay, so let's get some clarification. Let's clarify the Queen of Wands here for Pisces Spirit with the Queen of Wands, please and thank you. So you're feeling like you're connected to the situation. You notice how it's so weird, this devil in this devil card. The guy's eating. It looks like it's eating out of the palm of a hand. Interesting. There's definitely a need here for self-care, Pisces. They're causing confusion. They're causing these delays on purpose. Okay. And because you're kind of more focused on them than you are yourself, you're more worried if this connection is going to work or not. That may be what they're dangling over your head. It may be here, Pisces, that they are dangling this relationship over your head, right? Maybe that this situation isn't all that it's cracked out to be. There's definitely a need for self-care. Taking the focus back and putting it on self here is the sense that I'm getting, because this person, their focus is on themselves as well. They're focused on what they can get out of the situation. And again, a little bit of self-sabotage behavior coming out here in this reading. So let's get a couple cards for advice for Pisces. What is the advice for Pisces spirit in this connection moving forward? Advice for Pisces, please and thank you. Three of Wands. This person may, after you take a step back, try to come in with an apology, but I feel there's still this malicious intent that's kind of underlying this connection. Give me one more card here, Spirit. The Five of Swords is like tit for tat. It's like one up. Or like, oh, I gotta get the best of that person. In this card, you see how two people are walking away and the guy is still standing there with his swords drawn. Plotting. The plotting card. So be cautious. Be aware of that. Be aware that there's plotting going on. I feel like there is a need here to movement forward, but there's going to be slow movement forward. Whatever that means to you. But I ultimately feel here, Pisces, that you may eventually end up walking away from this person because I don't see them changing here. So let's get a power thought card. I am going to take a little bit deeper look into your person, okay? We are going to do an extended reading. We'll take a look into their intentions a little bit deeper, where this is headed. I always pull out the soul truth over there on Vimeo. So if you guys want to join, you're more than welcome. The link is below in the description box. I'm totally adequate for all situations. I am one with the power and wisdom of the universe. I claim this power, and it is easy for me to stand up for myself. I am totally adequate for all situations. So, Pisces, that is the message I have coming out for you guys for the month of March. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support. Thank you for liking, subscribing, sharing the content. You guys are all amazing. And I look forward to seeing your beautiful souls again soon. Namaste.